so that we may understand what we then ask to understand this morning. Father, we know that your word says you shall never gather your people in vain. And we know that, King of glory, we have not left our places and come to this place in vain, but you have a word for each and every one of us. And I pray that, Lord, King of glory, whoever has come here sick, Lord, you're going to touch them and you're going to heal them because you're God and you're full of power and strength. We pray that, King of glory, those who have come here discouraged, Lord, downcast, Father, their spirit are going to be lifted by the hearing of your word. We pray that, King of glory, none of us who has come in this place, they shall move out the same way. I pray that, Lord, your word is going to fall in a fertile soil. It is going to yield fruits, mighty Father, 160 and 30 for the honor and the glory of your holy name. Jehovah, Lord, I pray that no one will regret why they came to church today, but they are going to say that their spirit has been renewed, their strength has been renewed, their spirit man has been touched, and their lives are never the same again. We thank you, we give you glory, we give you praise and honor, Lord. May you give me utterance and anoint my lips that I may speak your will. Not what I think, not what I understand, Lord, but according to the understanding of the Spirit of God. I pray that, King of glory, you may use me as a vessel of honor so that I may deliver your will, nothing else but your will this morning. We give you glory and we give you all the glory for you deserve it, mighty Father. For it is in Jesus' name we pray and we trust. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I thank God. I will not say my name because my sister said it, and I also introduced myself another time here. But it's Elizabeth, if you want to hear it again. I want to just elaborate the word of God. As I have said, I just want to do as something kind of a teaching. I will try my best to teach today. Amen. Now Jesus gives a parable of a wise man and a foolish man, and both of them, they had a good intention to build a house. Amen. And he says that the first man was a wise man. Both of them, they were builders, but the first builder was a wise builder. Amen. And he says that this builder went on a rock, and he dug on that rock, and he built the foundation there. And the Bible says that after the foundation, he built the house. And after the house, there came a time, I believe it was a time of a testing. It was a time of testing the foundation of the house. Because the house is not what you can see outside, but the house is the foundation that you are not able to see. Only the builders of the house can tell how deep the foundation is, or rather was. Amen. When somebody wants to build like maybe a flat, and they want to begin with like a ground and they say first floor, if they have a vision maybe in the future to build a gorofa, they will need a very deep foundation. Amen. And maybe somebody will not be able to understand why is this person building like a crazy person. But because this person maybe has a vision in future, they want to bring the house high, bonus if you will. So they will ensure that the foundation, it is strong. And when they will want to maybe build that floor, second floor, they will not go back to the foundation, but they have already laid a strong foundation before they begin. And then the Bible says, great rain descended, and a great wind came and beat the house. And the floods came, because after the rain, of course, you expect floods. But the Bible says the house remained standing because the foundation of the house was very strong, or rather it was very deep. Praise the Lord. Amen. But Jesus then gives another example of another man who I believe he was a lazy man, or maybe he did not want to get tired. Unajua, kuna in life there are those people who don't want to pay the price. Even they don't want to work hard, they don't want to revise. And they will end up doing like my sister, what she has said. They want to write a Mwakenya and put it on their socks because they don't want to work hard. They don't want to make their mind tired, you know. For some reason, they just want to stay, to live and just make life as easy as it can be. But that's not all about life. If you want to succeed, you must have the foundation deep. Tell your neighbor that. And this man, no wonder Jesus calls him foolish, another out. And this man built the house, and it looked so good. Maybe I believe both houses, maybe they were looking the same from outside. Alijenga nyumba nzuri, maybe akapaka rangi vizuri, maybe akatumia mabati ya gharama kubwa, lakini that was not all the issue. The issue was all about the foundation. And because time of testing was to happen to all of them, then when the great rain descended and the floods came and the wind blew, the Bible says that the house fell. And Jesus says the fall of that house was great. Amen. Amen. Jesus says, let me read the verse. And a great was its fall. Verse 27. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the wind blew and beat on that house, and it fell. And a great was its fall. You know, Jesus emphasizes on the falling of the house because the falling was great, because the foundation was very weak. Because this man never took his time to think about what kind of a house he wanted to have, or rather, for how long he wanted to have that house. You know, if there was no rain which ever descended, if there were no floods which ever came, then that means the house of this man could have never fallen down. But it is during the time of testing when everybody was able to realize, Kuba, this man was just a total joker. It was during the time of trial when everybody was able to realize this man was not serious. He never did a serious job. He was never serious, though he has spent a lot of money in building that house, but it was just a shoddy job. Why? Because in the first place, he never took his time and ensured the foundation of the house was a strong foundation. And today I came to speak about having a strong foundation in Jesus. Amen. Amen. You know, we have many a time, especially the CU, we live a Christian life when we are in school. And I remember for what my sister said, that Christianity is not a religion, it's a lifestyle. Because if it is a lifestyle, then it means what you do in your house, it should never be different from what you do when you are in the public. Amen. That's why another girl told her teacher that, I think the Jesus of my mom is not the same Jesus of my teacher. Because the Jesus my mom teaches me, he seems to be a different Jesus. Because my mom can quarrel me, sometimes he can tell me unkind words, and yet he confesses that he knows Jesus. But my teacher seems to be totally different. Amen. And then you need to ask yourself a question, that when you are before people and when you are alone, or rather when you are with your family members and when you are in a congregation, do you display a different Jesus, or people can really see and say, this person is born again because of your deeds? And we as Christians, it is our initiative to make sure that we have a strong foundation in Christ. And that Matthew 16, 16, isn't it? The Bible says, let me just read it. It won't add as. When Jesus came into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" So they say, some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He said to them, "But who you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered and said, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus answered and said to him, "Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven, and I also say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven." Some people say that Jesus was referring Peter as to the rock, but that wasn't the case. Because there is no way Jesus could build his church on a man. Because a man is just a man. Amen. And there is no way Jesus could build a revelation on a man. But Jesus goes ahead and tells Peter, "You are Peter. And on this rock," referring to himself, "on this rock I'll build my church. And gates of hell shall not prevail against that church." And Jesus calls him himself a rock. And when we read this scripture, or rather the parable which Jesus is giving, and he's talking of a man building his house on a rock, then he was saying in simple terms that this man built his foundation on Jesus himself. Do you get the revelation? You know, I said I'm teaching. I don't know whether I'm being and teaching or I'm preaching. Amen. Maybe my sister will do me homiletics later. Bonus if you will. When Jesus is talking of a man building a strong house, he's talking of him building his house, or rather his faith in Jesus himself. Praise the Lord. Amen. You know, you need, there are some trees who was in a pando kwa kando ya mto. And you know, some of them you expect, some of them you expect them when the water comes, you expect them to be carried away. I don't know you kamti kana itoaje, but it just when the strong winds come, huwa inaenda tu kama inaenda kuanguka. Then when the wind goes, it just stands straight. It remains there. And you know, in the on the sand, or rather on the riverside, aku kwangi na mchanga yenye ambayo inaweza shikilia mizizi. But aku kamtu wa kwanza kanamea kanapeleka mizizi yake chini kabisa. So no matter what kind of many waters comes, that tree can never fall. Itaenda tu kama ni kama inaenda kuanguka, but it can never fall.